the real causes of high cholesterol levels. Cholesterol is a fatty substance that's found in every single cell within the human body. It's a very important building block for the membranes around your cells, as it helps to protect their structure and keep them stable. It also builds lipid rafts in your cells, which can help to protect them against getting infected by invaders like viruses or bacteria. Cholesterol is vital for building steroid hormones like testosterone, cortisol, and estrogen, and also building vitamin D through your skin. It's absolutely essential for building connections or synapses in your brain so that you can have a good and working memory. And finally, one of the most important benefits of cholesterol is that it helps to build bile in your liver and gallbladder, which helps your body to digest and process fats and absorb fat-soluble nutrients from your food, like vitamins A, D, E, K, and K2, and also some phytonutrients that come from plants. Now, when you go to the doctors to get a blood test, they'll usually measure your cholesterol by checking your HDL and LDL numbers. These are proteins which act as vehicles to carry cholesterol around your body where it needs to be. HDL is considered to be very healthy, as it helps to carry and remove excess cholesterol from your cells where it's not needed. Whilst LDL is also important for carrying cholesterol from your liver to your cells through your blood. Unfortunately, certain types of LDL called small dense LDL are very dangerous, as they contain cholesterol which can easily stick inside your artery walls and oxidize, raising the risk of heart attacks, blood clots, strokes, and diabetes. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the six main causes of high cholesterol levels and how to bring these numbers back into balance using nutrition and natural remedies. Just a quick reminder, this video is for educational purposes only, so do speak to your doctor if you have any medical concerns. One of the main causes of high total cholesterol levels or having too much LDL is due to having fatty liver disease. Your liver makes an important substance that's called bile, which is involved with breaking down fats and lipids in the body, like cholesterol and triglycerides. However, if you have any type of liver disease, you're overweight in the belly area, or you have gallbladder problems, you may not be making or releasing enough bile, which is causing your body to store more cholesterol. The second cause is eating processed sugars. The main reason that people have liver problems and too much cholesterol is because they eat too many processed carbohydrates, like refined sugars, high fructose corn syrup, or maltodextrin fillers, which are found in sweets, soda drinks, table sauces, jams, syrups, protein bars and shakes, and all of the junk foods. These processed carbohydrates cause inflammation in your liver and cause the cholesterol that's stored in your LDL to become dysfunctional, which can clog up your arteries and increase your risk of heart attacks or blood clots. The third cause of high cholesterol is high cortisol levels. When you're emotionally stressed out, your body produces more of a hormone called cortisol as part of the fight or flight mechanism. Basically, this hormone raises up your blood sugars, tightens your muscles, and it helps your body to get ready to fight or run away as it perceives danger. Unfortunately, if you remain stressed out and anxious for weeks, months, or even years, this can continue to keep raising your blood sugars. These high blood sugars are converted into fat, which raises the amount of LDL cholesterol and triglycerides in your blood, and this can raise the risk of diabetes and a cascade of other health problems. If you're finding this information helpful so far, please tap the like button, subscribe, and turn all notifications on to stay updated with my latest health and nutrition tips. Coming back now to cause number four, which is, surprisingly, losing weight. If you're following a diet or an exercise plan and you're losing the weight, it's very normal for your cholesterol levels to go up. You see, as your body is burning fat, the cholesterol that's stored within your fat cells has to get transported to your liver for elimination. This means that there's more cholesterol in your blood temporarily because your body needs to break it down in order to get rid of it. As you reach your weight loss goals, your numbers may go back to normal, as this is usually a temporary situation. This is not a problem at all, as long as you have enough bile to help break down these fats, but we'll talk more about this later in the video. The fifth cause of high cholesterol is gut dysbiosis. Inside your gut, there are over 100 trillion friendly bacteria that help your body to produce vitamins, brain chemicals, and bile. Studies show that these friendly microbes help to regulate cholesterol levels and raise your HDL, which is the good cholesterol, to lower the risk of heart problems. Unfortunately, if you suffer from any type of gut disease like SIBO, IBS, celiac disease, indigestion, or ulcers, it's very likely that your LDL cholesterol will go higher because of the damage that's happening to the walls of your intestines. The liver starts to produce more LDL to help repair the damage, but this cholesterol can become oxidized and cause other problems in your body, like heart disease. And finally, cause number six, which is also common, is an overactive thyroid. People who have an overactive thyroid, which is a hyperthyroid, not a hypothyroid, also tend to have higher LDL cholesterol levels. The thyroid gland in your neck controls many different parts of your metabolism, and if it's overworked, it can produce more of the dangerous type of LDL, which can cause plaque in your arteries. If you do suffer from this condition, you may need to get more vitamin B1 in your diet, and be sure to avoid taking bile or tudka as a supplement, which can make the problem worse in this particular situation. Other causes of high cholesterol. In addition to these six main causes, high cholesterol can also be caused by diabetes, a mutation in the CETP gene, eating too many vegetable oils and trans fats, which are inflammatory and damage the liver, drinking alcohol, which also damages the liver and causes problems with cholesterol metabolism. Nicotine from cigarettes or vaping lowers HDL and can raise LDL. Medications like beta blockers, diuretics, birth controls, or steroids can mess with your cholesterol levels. If you've had your gallbladder removed, this can cause a lack of bile, so cholesterol and fats don't break down properly in your body. And this can also be caused by a niacin or a vitamin B3 deficiency. How to lower cholesterol? Now that you've learned all about the main causes of high cholesterol levels, we'll take a look at six ways to help normalize your LDL and HDL numbers. 1. Take 2 to 4 bile acid capsules every single day to help support your liver and your gallbladder in breaking down cholesterol. Look for a brand which contains ox bile, or for a more powerful version, you can take tudka or taurodeoxycholic acid. Make sure to avoid this, however, if you have an overactive thyroid. As a side note, I'll put some links down below the video to share my favorite products, which you may also want to research in your own time. 2. Cut out inflammatory vegetable oils and trans fats from fast foods. Stop smoking and stop drinking, as all of these damage your liver and accumulate bad types of cholesterol in your body. Be sure to stay away from foods that contain high fructose corn syrup and sugar, like table sauces, jams, syrups, sweets, and soda drinks as much as you possibly can. 3. Eat anti-inflammatory foods to help reduce the dangerous small dense LDL cholesterol, including avocados, sardines, pistachios, extra virgin olive oil, and walnuts. Focus specifically on eating more omega-3 rich fish, like salmon, sardines, mackerel, herring, or you could take a fish oil or a cod liver oil supplement. 4. If you have a concern about heart attacks, you suffer from atherosclerosis, or you have heart disease, consider taking niacin at a dosage of 500 to 1000 milligrams per day. Make sure that the product that you choose is extended release niacin, not niacinamide. This will cause a flushing sensation within 2 hours of taking it, as it helps to open up the blood vessels. Niacin has been shown to increase HDL and lower LDL for a healthier cholesterol profile. 5. Exercise for at least 10 to 20 minutes twice per week, using high-intensity interval training like biking, running, weightlifting, or deadlifts, which are all excellent. Exercise will help cholesterol to be transported to the right places in your body, and it will lower oxidative stress, making LDL more stable and less likely to cause damage inside your arteries. And finally, number 6, consume more soluble fiber and prebiotics in your diet from fermented foods like sauerkraut, kimchi, pickles, berries, chia seeds, leafy green vegetables, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and cabbage. These foods will help to boost the amount and the diversity of the friendly microbes that live in your gut, which will naturally reduce your cholesterol levels. Now, if you'd like to learn about 6 vitamins that actively help to unclog your arteries of plaque, go ahead and tap on this video on the screen now. Thank you so much for watching my video today, and as always, I wish you great health, wealth, and happiness.